Hello and welcome to Affinity. There are many ways to do masks, and an unusual way is with curves, and actually it's quite good. Let's have a look. Let's go to curves, bring up a curves layer, here we go. Now because we want a mask, it's going to be in black and white, we want to convert it to grey. So grey. Nothing happens immediately, but the moment I touch the curve, something will happen. So if I just touch it a little bit here, bing, there we go. So what I'm going to do before I actually move it down here, I want to have a look at there, where this is on the scale between dark and light. So I'll use the picker. So I click on that, click on here, and then I have to move it a little bit. And here you go. There it is. Can I pick another piece? Yeah, there. So this spike here seems to kind of cover it. So we know where to go now. So if I reset that, and now to make it black, I just drag the white end all the way down to the bottom. Then I need to put in a left and a right range there. And then just grab the middle and pull it up. And here we go, here's a mask appearing, and there's the area that we want. When you do this, by the way, if you go all the way to the top, you can get a square thing. So you get quite hard edges to it. And if you, there's one dot there, but there's no dot here, which means if I hold the bottom here, I can slide this backwards and forwards. And select different areas. I can't quite do it here because of it sort of looks a bit different. So if I wanted to do it from the bottom, the other side, I could just take that dot, move it across to the other side. Now I can do it this way. The other thing to do then is if you want to feather the edge, and a way to do that is bring this in a bit. Because if you do this, see it comes in from both sides at once, because it's wanted trying to get to a curve. So if you move this one out, thing to watch out for is if you start here and you start to move some of these, you can start getting funny bits happening. So let's do that, and let's start from this again. Let's bracket it so it's move that dot over there. There we go, and bring this in a bit here. So I've got the width here kind of covering that. Then I'll bring this into the middle here, let it feather off a bit. There's a bit coming in the edge there, but that's okay. Normally what I'd do as well is I'd move the bottom out to give the sort of bottom of the fade, because the angle of here is giving the amount of feathering on this selection. Some things are happening peering down the bottom here, but that's okay. There's stuff over here as well, don't worry about that. Because what I'm going to do is say, okay, I'll take that as it is. But now, because I've got black and white here, I could convert it to a mask, but I would need an extra layer. I should have duplicated the original layer and so on. But we don't need to do that, because I can go down to channels. And the red, green and blue here are all going to be the same, because it's black and white. So any of those, I right click and go load to pixel selection. Now, I've selected that area. So it's useful for selecting as well by tone. And now I can turn off that layer. So I can go back to my original here. I can go to the main one here. And actually, before I go any further, I can say, let's deselect some of this stuff. I'm going to keep the bit in the lake because it's kind of reflect the sky. But I go to the selection brush tool. Make sure I've got subtract selected. And then I should be able to paint. I need to, yeah, go on here and paint over this. There we go. So there we go. So I'm painting away the selection I don't want. It's a bit up there. The brush is a bit big, but I think that's good enough. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this. So all you need to use a selection of some sort. So I'm doing an adjustment. So I'm going to go to another curves. I've got to have another curves because when I bring the curves in, it picks up the selection as a mask. So I can hit Control D to get rid of the mask. And now when I move this curve up and down, it's affecting just that area. So if I look at the sky over here, I can, bring that there. That's looking a bit better, isn't it? If this is a bit bright here, because I'm on, make sure I'm selected on that curve there, go to the paintbrush tool, make sure I've got black to paint away this here, and see as I go over here, it's going to paint it back. There we've got the opacity is 50%. So let's take that down to about 30-ish, say. Make the brush a bit bigger with the left and right square bracket, and then I can paint over here just to take that down a bit, maybe a little bit more. There we go. And that's how you do it. Masking with curves. Whatever next. Thank you very much for watching.